Hello everyone, welcome to the fifth online session of design of pre-stressed concrete structure. So in these sessions we will solve some more problem regarding the analysis of section for flexure. So as I mentioned in the earlier class itself, we are not going to design first, we are going to the analysis part. So analysis of a section for flexure, we are going to study some more problems regarding these parts. So hopefully you remember that in annexure D there is a formula to calculate the moment of resistance, okay, to find out the moment of resistance for a rectangular and a T section, okay, when the neutral axis lies in the flange for T section. Remember that. So you have to refer the code book IS 1343 2012, page number 51, annexure D. So this page you have to remember for analysis of PSC section for flexure. So there is a formula for moment of resistance, as well as there is a table 11 which you have to refer. So for table 11 you have to refer you have to find out the value of F, P, B, as well as the XU value, whether to check the neutral axis lies in the flange or the web. So for rectangular section it's okay, for T or I section, other sections, you have to check whether the neutral axis lies in the web or the flange. So this is the reinforcement ratio. First you have to find the reinforcement ratio, then you have to check whether it's a pre-tension member or a post-tension member with effective bond. So for table number 11 in 2012, there is only one case, that is effective bond, post-tension with effective bond, where the gap between the tendons as well as the concrete or the duct space is been filled by cement slurry, that is mean grouting. Okay, grouting has been done. So you have to find these values, okay. First check, find the value of XU, check whether the neutral axis lies in the web or the flange of a T or a I section, then find the value of FPB to get, after getting the value of FPB, you can substitute in the moment of resistance formula to get the value of moment of resistance. So if you refer IS 1343 1980, so table number 12, condition for ultimate limit state for post-tension rectangular beams having unbounded tendons. So this is case for unbounded tendons. So here you have to find the reinforcement ratio first, then you have to also find the effective span to depth ratio. Remember that, you have to find out the effective span to depth ratio. After that you have to interpolate two values to get the value of FPU. Okay, FPU, F, where FP is the characteristic tensile strength of steel, which is equal to 1600 for maximum number of cases. And first, before that, check whether your neutral axis lies in your web or the flange. Okay, so this is how we are going to solve some more problems now. So next problem, a post tension beam with unbounded tendons is of rectangular cross section, B is given as well as D value is given. The cross section area of the pre-stressing steel is 3000 mm². So the cross section area is given. The effective pre-stress after considering all the losses is 1000 MPa. The effective span of the beam made up of M40. So M40 concrete is 15 meters. The span is given and FCK is given. Estimate the ultimate moment of resistance of the section using the caudal provision. So for this problem, this is a post tension as well as the unbounded tendon, so you have to refer the old code book IS 1343 1980. So you have to refer this code book for solving this problem. This is the least probable case of you people getting this type of problem. If you get also, so to get an idea, I'm going to solve two problems regarding this post tension with unbounded tendons. Okay, so this page will be provided, not the code book. So this page, extra page, will be provided in your examination if post-tension unbounded tendons comes in your problems. So first write down what is given. B value is given, D value is given. So they have correctly mentioned the small d value, so it is taken as small d equal to 1000 mm. AP is given, effective pre-stress after losses is been given 1000 MPa, and length is given 15 meters. So in post-tension unbounded tendons, the one more value they needed to provide you is the length span. Without this value you cannot solve the problem. So whenever there is a length given, remember that it is for unbounded tendons most of the times. Okay, then from table number 12, so you have to find out this ratio AP into FP into BD by FCK. So first you have to find that value. So AP will be 3000 and FPE will be 1000. Effective pre-stress after loss is 1000 megapascal. So it is given here, effective pre-stress after considering all losses is 1000 megapascal. Then B 5000, D 1000 and FCQ value is 40. You will get the ratio value as 0.15. So this is the value of reinforcement ratio. So this is the value of reinforcement ratio. Now for that reinforcement ratio, you have to find out the values of FPU and FPE. So before finding out, you need one more term, that is effective span by effective depth. So first thing, again you have to find out the effective span by effective depth. Effective span is 15 into 1000, effective depth is 1000. So 1000 is the effective depth and effective span is given as 15 meters. So 15 into 1000, you'll get the value as 15. So for that, now here is your first thing. Okay, first 15 comes here. So one thing, 15 here, effective span to depth ratio. So these three values are for effective span to depth ratio. Okay, top three ratios will be there. Between these three itself you will get the values. Okay, the span will be provided. If there is more than that, you could not provide it. So this is the effective span to depth ratio. Now the next part is to calculate the value of, for 0.15, how much is the value. So there is no value here, you have to find the value. So for 0.15, for 15, what is the value required? Same case for here, you have to find. So you have to interpolate between 1.20 and 1.36. In here it is 1.46 and 1.52. So between these values you have to interpolate to get the value of XU by D, and here to find the value of FU by FP, you have to interpolate between those values. So same thing I have written here. For 0.15, 20, it is 1.20, and for 10, it is 1.36. If you interpolate using your calc, don't do any manual calculation, directly using your calc, if you interpolate, you'll get the value as 1.28. So FPU by FPE value equal to 1.28, the ratio value. So therefore FPU will be equal to 1.2 into 1000, which is given in the problem. So 1280 newton per mm square. So this is the value of FPU. Now the same thing for XU by D. So if you have seen 0.46 and 0.52, so 0.46 as well as 0.52 for 20 and 10, so XU by D equal to 0.49. if you interpolate using your calc, you'll get this value. So check for in your Google itself how to interpolate using your respective calcs. It is easy. So if you interpolate that, and you will get the value as 0.49. so XU by D equal to 0.49. so therefore the value of XU is 490 mm. So then moment of resistance, easy formula, FPU into AP into D minus 0.42 XU. So 1880, which you have found out, AP is given 3000, D is given 1000, minus 0.42 into XU, which you have found out, 490. Therefore moment of resistance is equal to 3049.7 kilonewton per meter. Remember here you will get something into 10 to the power of 6 newton per mm. Then you have to convert it to get it in this unit. So your answers, final answer should be in kilonewton per meter. Whatever you are getting off in your calc will be in terms of newton per mm. If you had solved the earlier sessions also problems, you will get something value, okay, in 10 to the power of 6 in your calcs. So after, then after rearranging to get this unit, you have to rearrange it so that the value of mu equal to 3049.7 kilonewton per meter, because everything you have substituted here in mm, remember that. So this is the value of mu, moment of resistance, for this section. So here the problem ends. Next problem, a pre-tensioned PSC beam of I section with 160 into 70 flanges. So flange width and depth is given, with thickness of web is 50 mm and overall depth of I section is 320 mm. Overall depth is given. The beam is pre-stressed with 4 high tension steel wires of 7 mm at an effective depth of 265. So an effective depth is given. and FCK equal to 50 newton per mm square, FP is 1600 newtons per mm square, find the ultimate flexural strength. You have to find the ultimate flexural strength. So this is how your problem looks like. So effective depth, they have only given 265 mm. And they have given you the flange width as well as the depth. Then they have given you the value of web width as well as the overall depth. So this is the overall depth of the I section. So this is how your I section looks like. Draw the I section first, visualize the problem and draw the sketch of whatever the section they have told you. So that is the basic step, first step. Then pre-tension, it is mentioned. Then FCK value is given, FP value is given. So they have not directly given you the value of area of cable. They have mentioned you that four cables have been used of 7 mm diameter. So therefore, area of the cable AP equal to 4 into pi by 4. So pi by 4 into diameter square, that is 7 square. Therefore, 154 mm square is the area of the cable. Next, depth of the neutral axis. So let us first assume that neutral axis lies in the flange itself. Okay. For simple I section like this, where the depth is very less, you can assume the neutral axis lies in the flange itself. So therefore, what you have assumed is XU is less than 70 mm. So this, you are assuming that neutral axis lies somewhere here. Now, table number 11. Okay. So this is code book IS 1343. 2012. Remember, for only post-tension unbounded case, you have to refer 1980. Other cases, you have to refer 2012 itself. So AP into FP into B suffix F. So when you are taking it as a flange, you have to take this as B suffix F, D into FCK. So AP value, you have calculated 154. FP is given as 1600. B suffix F, width of the flange is given as 160. Into D value 265 into 50. Therefore, the ratio will be equal to 0.116. For this ratio, now you need to find out the value of XU. First, find out the value of XU by D ratio value. Then find out the value of the FPU. So next, as I mentioned earlier itself. So for 0.116, you won't get the direct value. So table number 11, go to table number 11 in the IS 1343 in page 51. So go to that page. I'm not going again. So hopefully by now you would have got an idea of how to find the value XU by D. For 0.10, it is 0.217. For 116, you need to find out how much it is. So 0.15, 0.326. So XU by D will be equal to 0.252 from the table. So interpolating using your calc, you'll get this value. XU equal to 0.252 into the value of D, that is 265, you'll get it as 66.78 mm, which is less than 70 mm. Hence, your assumption is correct. If not, you have to solve the whole steps by finding out the value of the area of the steel in the flange, area of the steel in the web. Then finding out all other respective values. Okay, so here it is not required. Then again, you have to see the table number 11 again to find out the value of FPU. Okay, so here in table number 11 itself, for FPU, the value for this is equal to 1, and for value for 0.15 is also equal to 1. The value of FPU divided by 0.8787 FY. So the value is equal to 1 for 0.10 and 0.15, it is also 1. Therefore, FPU by 0.87 FP equal to 1. Therefore, the value of FPU equal to 1 into 0.87 into 1600. That value is directly equal to 1392 newton per mm square. Okay, so this is the value of FPU. Now, the problem is very easy. Just substitute. Since the neutral axis lies within the flange, MU equal to the direct formula which is given in the page number 51, FPU into AP into D minus 0.42 XU. This is given in the code book itself, IS 1343 2012, in page number 51. So in page number 51, it has been directly given. So you're substituting the values and you will Using your calc, you will get this value, 50.8 kilonewton meter. So this is the amount of moment of resistance, okay? So here the problem ends. This is the simplest problem which you will might get for 6 marks. Next problem. An asymmetrical I-section girder has the following sectional properties. Width and thickness of the top flange, okay? Width as well as the thickness. Thickness of the web. Centroidal section is located at 540 mm from the top. So your neutral axis from the top is 580 mm from the top. The girder used over a span is 40 meter. So this girder which you are using is of 40 meter. The tendons are unbounded with, so unbounded tendons, okay? As I mentioned earlier, we are going to solve two problems regarding the unbounded case. With cross section area of 7000 mm are parabolic with eccentricity. So E value is also given. Eccentricity of 1200 mm at the center of the span, given FCK, given FPE, pre-stressed after all losses. If they have given this value, you can take this value. If not given, you can directly take it as 1600 newton per mm square. Pre-stressed after all losses, estimate the ultimate flexural strength. So you have to again find out the ultimate flexural strength. So this is how your problem looks like. First draw the sketch. So the value where the centroidal axis lies, okay? So from the top, they have given you as 540 mm. This is where your axis lies, the neutral axis from the top, okay? Then the value of E from the neutral axis to this is been given as E value 1220. Therefore, your D value which is required for you solving this problem is the distance from the top to the neutral axis, from neutral axis to the half of the center of the tendon. So that value will be equal to D. So here they have not directly given you the effective depth. Instead, they have given you like this. So there you have to find out the value of D first. And unbounded they have given. They have given you the length. They have given you the value of AP equal to 7000 mm square and FCK equal to 45 newton per mm square and FPE equal to 1200 newton per mm square. So therefore, assume the neutral axis lies within the web. First step is to assume, okay? You need not need to assume because they have already given it has 580 mm, which means that your neutral axis lies here itself, okay? Mm, and it is greater than 360 mm. So AP equal to APF plus APW, which is equal to 7000. So therefore, APF equal to 0.45 FCK, B suffix F minus B suffix W, DF by FPE. So substituting all the values which is given in the problem itself. So then substituting all the values, you will get the value of APF equal to 5832 mm square. This is the area of the tendons in the flange. Then area of the tendons in the web will be equal to total area minus the area of the tendons in the flange. So this will be equal to 1168 mm square. Then you have to go for table 12 for unbounded tendons. You have to find out the reinforcement ratio. So here the major change, AP will be APW and B will be BW because the neutral axis lies in the web. Then substituting it, you'll get the value of reinforcement ratio. So everything you have found out, 1168, this is given as the loss value. Then 240 which you have found out, sorry, it's given, D value is given and FCK is 45. Therefore, this value is 0.72. Then LE by D, 40 by 1800. Therefore, it is 22.22. Now, here you have to find out. So it is, here it will be 22.22. So this is the value. Then, what is the value? 0.072, that effective ratio, 0.072. So here, somewhere here, the value lies. So here you have to interpolate two times. One, either you can interpolate vertically. First, interpolate between this and this value to get the here, this mid value, okay? Again, interpolate between this value and this value, you'll get the one more value here, okay? Two values you'll get. Then again interpolate for 30 and 20 to get the value for 22.22. This is one method. So for finding out this one value, you have to interpolate three times. Then again, to find out the value okay? Otherwise you can interpolate in a horizontal way. First interpolate for 20 and 30, for 0.16 and 0.56, get the value here, okay? That I will explain in the here, okay? Here in between these two values, okay? So these are the four values which you need to consider, and 22.22. So this is the value. So somewhere here in the between. So three times interpolation. So first interpolate between these two values, okay, to get some value here. Then interpolate between this as well as the this value to get some value here. Then you can interpolate it in the this way, vertical manner. Either two times horizontal interpolation with one vertical, or two times vertical interpolation with one horizontal. It's your choice, however you can interpolate. So three times you have to interpolate in your calci to get the value here. Remember that I have highlighted all the values which they have taken. So this is how it looks for XU by D, 0.16, 0.16. So 0.16, 0.16, 0.30, 0.32. So 0.30, 0.36. So first interpolation between this and this value will get it has. So they have interpolated horizontally first, okay? Horizontally I have interpolated. So interpolation horizontally, you'll get this value. Then vertical interpolation first. It is easy, you can do it in both way. You'll get the same answer as 0.228. Remember, if you interpolate between these two value and get this value, and interpolate again between these two value and get this value, you will end up with this 0.228 itself. So XU by D equal to 0.228, and 0.228 into 1800 will be 140.4 mm. That is the value of DF, okay? So this is the where the neutral axis basically lies, okay? That will be the, what they have given you will be the centroidal distance, okay, from the top fiber. So this is where your neutral axis lies, and the assumption what is you have done is correct, okay? Next, same thing. For hence the neutral axis lies within the web, assumption is correct. Therefore again, for you have to do it for to find out the value of FPU. So three times interpolation again, 1.21, 1.32, 1.18, 1.26. So these values 1.12, 1.32. So again interpolating between 1.21 and 1.32 for 22.22, you'll get this value. Same thing, again interpolating between these two value, you will get the value as 1.24. Then vertical interpolation, first two times horizontal interpolation, one time vertical. You can do vice versa also. So therefore the PU by PE value will be something 1.27. Therefore the PU value is 1.27 into 1200. Therefore the total value of PU is 1524 newton per mm square. Therefore moment of resistance mu equal to, so this formula you have to remember, FPU into APW into D minus 0.42 XU, then FPE into, so remember there is FPE as well as FPU, both are not same, okay? This is what you have calculated using table number 12. This is what they have given after all the losses. Remember that FPE APF into D minus DF by 2, substituting that you will get the moment of resistance value mu equal to 14.23 into 10 to the power of 9 newton per mm. So this is the value of the moment of resistance, okay? So this is how we will get the value of moment of resistance if there is a post tension unbonded case. So next, this is your assignment problem. I have given you two assignments problem in this session. So solve this in your assignments book if you have it, or otherwise solve it in A4 sheet or any other book and keep it ready. So thank you.